Ahoy mateys, and welcome back to a new tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create the IR LED sensors for your GUN4IR. Shout out to Raymond Dye over at RPEG Electronics for his great tutorials. Going to need a PCB board, 4 27 ohm resistors, 12 IR LEDs, a USB 2.0 A-type male power plug, a DC female power jack, and some electrical wire. See links below. Let's cut a 5x6 set of holes out of our PCB board. We'll need to create 4 pieces. Now, when inserting your IR LEDs, you'll need to have the long legs on the left-hand side when installing. Do this for all 3 IR LEDs. Now we need to pull the IR LEDs out about a half an inch. Arr, don't have steady hands like Raymond. This can be a little tricky, so take your time. Then bend the LEDs back to lock them into place. Let's solder all 6 points. When this is complete, bend the far right lead up. Should look like this. Now we can install the resistor. It will need to go into this location. Make sure to leave some room to be able to bend the resistors to this side of the PCB board. Should look like this. When complete, bend the leads back to lock them in place. Now we need to bend the IR LEDs to the correct position. The first pin needs to be straight down. Pin 2 and 3 need to be crossed over to each other. Pin 4 and 5 also need to be crossed over to each other. Should look like this. Let's solder each point. Make sure to connect the resistor lead to the IR LED lead with some solder. When soldering the crossover pins, just apply some solder between each lead. Should look like this. Cut the excess leads off. Need to repeat this process 3 more times to complete all 4 IR LED sensors. Now we can cut some wires for the length of your TV. We'll need 4 sets of wire, 2 for the left and right, and 2 for the top and bottom. For example, if you have a 32-inch TV monitor, you will need 2 20-inch long cables for the horizontal and 2 12-inch cables for the vertical. It's okay if you give yourself some extra wire for each end. After cutting your wires, trim off about 1 inch for each side. We can always cut the wires if we have excess. pull one side of your wires, twist the red wires together. Do the same for the black wires. Should look like this. Now for the DC power jack, we will need to trim off the ends and remove some cable shielding. Trim off about an inch from each end. Now twist the wires onto the set of wires we just twisted, red to red, black to black. Should look like this. Let's put some solder on each set of wires. You can either use electrical tape or shrink tubing to the ends of each wire. Now we can attach each wire end to the IR LED sensor we created. To make it easier, put some solder on each wire first. Then solder each wire to the board. Should look like this when complete. Do the same for each IR LED sensor. When everything is complete, we can test out the IR LED sensors. Plug in the USB power cord into the power jack and then into the power brick. You can use any phone charging brick you have lying around. Now, when testing the IR LED sensors, just turn on your camera on your phone and take a look. You should see a purple light emitting from each LED. I guess some Apple phone cameras cannot see infrared, so use an Android phone. When you confirm that all the IR LED lights are working, you can place Velcro onto each board and place them onto your TV. Run the calibration tool inside the GUN4IR GUI for the correct placement of each sensor. And that's it for the IR LED sensors. Going to make more videos in the future on how to create a GUN4IR light gun from the ground up. If you like this video and want to see more, whip the like button, swashbuckle the subscribe button, and batten down the bell for future video notifications. Until next time, buckos, it's the arcade pirate sailing out.